We're checking in here. Gleason's Gym, Brooklyn, New York. You know, anytime we come through here, we got to catch up with the man in the left of the screen, Delen Blimp, Parsley. Looks like we just snuck in on a game of dominoes in here, but what we're really trying to do is put a little shine to this man here to the right. Blimp, why don't you do us the honors of giving a brief introduction?
Well, this is my man Taurus Sykes right here. I've been dealing with Taurus for over 15, 16 years.
And 20
and better. I mean, he's been around. We started from Best Style and everything. But now he's telling me, you know, that his last career, his pro fights, you know, that was his amateur career. And this right here, everything is getting ready to get back on top where he belongs right now. He's 30-5. And he's back in the gym and we're working hard trying to get things right. So, you know, we're just here doing the things we're supposed to do if we get what we want to get to.
Now, Dad, Taurus, talk. I'm sorry, Blint, didn't mean to cut you off.
But, you know, we can sit here and talk about it all day and say how much hard work we're doing. At the end of the day, everything lays in this man's hands, you know what I'm saying? He got to be the one to put his ass on the line and make his mind up what he want to do and what he's going to do, you know what I'm saying? I can just give him the water. He got to drink it, you know what I'm saying?
No doubt.
So, you see what he has to do about it.
Now, so let's talk a little bit about working with this man here, Blimp. You know, kind of from the start, you know, what led to, you know, the two of you linking back up?
Well, I've been working with Blimp for over 20 years. You know, we started working in the 90s, like 90, what's that, 92, 93?
Yeah.
And we was off and on that time, you know, because we clashed that time. But I realized he's the trainer for me, he's the man for me, and he grew me up. From when I was young, and I realized that he's the man I need in my corner. Because everything that he told me that I was doing before, that it was the right thing I was doing, but I didn't believe it was the right thing I was doing. So when I stepped away from him, then I realized that what he said was right, and everything he said came right back to me the way he told me to do it. So if I did it the first time, we wouldn't really be here right now like this. You know what I mean? We be where we supposed to be.
Right.
And that's on the T.O.P. I think. You know?
And what were some of the things, you know, along the way that led you to realize that the things Blimp was teaching you, you know, back then still ring true now? And, you know, the kind of, you know, that moment where the light bulb went on almost?
Just basically taking it more serious and being more focused and being more dedicated to the craft. You know, I used to train and then go hang out in the streets. Blimp used to see me, or his friends used to be like, yo, I saw your fighter at the party, this and that and that. You know, I wasn't really taking it serious because there wasn't no real pressure on me. You know, I was just doing it and I had the natural ability to get it done. So, you know, even though I wasn't getting that many knockouts, I was doing enough just to keep fighters off me and win fights and then go out and party and hang out and bullshit, really.
Right.
You know, it wasn't no real purpose. Because I was young at that time. Now I have a purpose, I have a family, I have a wife, I have daughters, you know, and I want to be able to leave something for them, you know. So that's basically what it is. And just everything that Blimp was telling me years ago, he tell me to today. That's his format of training. And that's what I realized that I need by analyzing my own career and analyzing what I was doing wrong.
Right.
If I would have listened, you know, and I wasn't listening. Because I felt that I had it and I'm going to do it my way, and I've been doing it my way. But my way wasn't the right way. And the first time around, I did it my way. Now I'm going to do it Blimp way.
Right.
And I'm just blessed to really have a second chance, meaning that I'm not a beat up fighter. I'm not all bruised up and punished. You know, as you can see, I'm talking to you. And I still have the ability and I still have the drive and the determination to get it done. And that's what I'm doing.
Right. And now, Blimp, it's obvious you can see the maturity that's, you know, that this has occurred over here. Not saying I was on the other side of it, but this is definitely a mature man sitting here in front of us today, you know. But what were some of the other things? You know, a lot of trainers, you know, if a former fighter came back to him that, you know, for whatever reason, they might have parted ways at one time. They might not want to take that fighter back. What are some of the things you saw to know it would be worth your while to connect again?
Well, like he just said, you know, he was never a beat up fighter. I never seen him get beat up or getting punished. And you know, that's a good thing, because you can come back and have a second career as long as you didn't get beat up too much. He wasn't getting knocked out. He never got beat up. And like he said, you know, he's back. He realized a lot of things that I was saying, you know, was true. And he sat down, he called me, and we had like a 3-hour meeting, which, you know, it was good. He said some things, what he's going to do and what he's not going to do, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, talk, you know, you can say anything you want to say to a person. The only thing I always tell them, don't sit here and talk me to death. Let's get to work. Let's start working and let's do the things we're supposed to do. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, he haven't had his first sparring yet. But after his first sparring, we'll know everything that's going on. I mean, not everything. I'm going to give him at least 3 or 4 sparring sessions to see what he looks like, make sure he still want to do this, make sure he's still capable of doing this. But the training so far, I mean, he's doing everything I'm asking him to do. The 30 minutes of rope, the shadow boxing, the bag work, everything is looking good. But, you know, what we're really looking for is, you know, like I said, he's back and we're here and he's 30-5. And, I mean, you know, this is going to be seen all over the world and everywhere. If you have any heavyweight that you think is good and he's ready to try something, he's ready to make a move, I got my guy, you got your guy. Let's see what we can do. You know what I mean? You can always get in touch. The number's still the same, 718-490-4750. Hit me up and we can make this happen.
No doubt.
I'm liking the things I'm seeing, so I don't have a problem. I'm quite sure you don't have a problem with your guys. So let's make it do what it do. This is what fighters do. They fight.
There it is. Now, Taurus, go ahead and take us home. Any closing comments?
Well, just to piggyback off of what Blimp said, you know, I'm putting in the work and I'm doing what I'm supposed to do and I'm enjoying it because I'm seeing what I put out is coming back, just like he told me the first time around, you know, and I'm definitely up for it. I'm with it and I'm going to put everything I have in because I saw what them streets bring and I ain't with that. Mm-hmm. I ain't trying to go to jail. I'm not trying to get killed. I'm trying to be with my family and live life and do it the way I know I can do it. So with that being said, I'm just ready and I'm willing and I'm able. And with Blimp, we're going to take it to the TOP this time around. It ain't
we
no
definitely
plan.
Going EAT.
Yeah, we're going EAT. So it ain't no game plan this time around and I'm putting everything in it. And I'm mature and I'm ready this time around and I know what to do. So I'm all the way with it.
There you have it now.
That's what it is.
Blimp, any last remarks you have?
Nah, like I said, you know what I'm saying? We're ready, we're able. Give me that call. Let's do it. Middle of December, January. I know you got somebody that need to fight, that need Christmas money. Give us a call. Let's get to work. Let's do something.
There it is. All right, on this side over here, I want to thank you both for sharing a little bit of time on your side. But, you know, you got both got things you got to get to going to do. So this is the first of many. We'll be back. We're going to be charting this so y'all can follow this journey. And you know how it happens whenever Resolution Sports slides by Gleason's gym. We're always going to be knocking on this door right here.
Happens big, baby.
But thank you both one last time.
No problem. Thank you.